Hey, this is a example of a SAT prep question that some of you guys actually overthink and try to solve this when you don't actually need to solve it to figure out the answer. Really, I guess there's couple things you need to know. You need to know what a system of equations is and what it means to have exactly two real solutions. In a system of equations, you'll usually have two lines that cross, and that would be your solution, would be the point at which they cross. So really, it's just asking for what points, if you plug them in, what values of a and b, if you plug them into this parabola, will give you two intersections with the line y equals 3. So this kind of makes you need to know what these values are doing. The sign in front of the a, plus or minus, plus makes it open up. Negative makes it open down always. The coefficient in front of the x will, if it's greater than 1, will make it wider. If it's less than 1 but greater than 0, it'll make it more narrow. And the b just does a, if it's positive, shift up, negative, shift down. So we want to know what parabola will cross the line y equals 3. So this is y equals 3. So let's start with a. We got a equals negative 2, b is 2. So we know that there's no horizontal shift here, so that it's going to be a maximum because it opens down since it's negative 2. For A, so it's going to be a maximum right here, and it's going to open down, and it's starting at 2. That's why I put it at y equals 2. So that will never cross y equals 3. So that's not right. We have negative 2, b equals 4. So if we move the maximum here, now you have two real solutions. So that looks like the answer, but let's just double check the other ones. We have b equals 4 and opens up. That will never cross. And you have b equals 3 and opens up kind of wide. That actually has one real solution. So your answer is this one, which was B. You don't really need to do any math here. The visual graph does help picture everything though.